We're going to talk about restoring the rule of law. It's so important that we talk about the rule of law because, quite frankly, it's what keeps us, our society together. It's so simple, we take it for granted. I can tell you that we have an adage that justice delayed is justice denied.
We've heard a lot about the issue of accountability, particularly from the president, and yet we've seen almost nothing in terms of real accountability measures being put out there.
So we've got all over 30 czars, and they fall into the same category of this lack of accountability.
And it's just not who these folks are that we don't know. It's what they step on, dictating winners and losers in terms of the auto dealerships, all directed under the leadership of a czar. The czars are just stepping all over the Constitution.
Several months ago, I was mystified by something that was happening in our country. We were shutting down auto dealerships. Not a single auto dealership in this country is owned by the manufacturers. Every auto dealership is an independent dealership, hiring people, paying taxes, selling cars.
The rule of contract is sacred. If you don't have that, which we've had for the history of our nation, then the rules of commerce come tumbling down. We have seen in this Congress bill after bill after bill spending billions and billions and billions of dollars that we get in the middle of the night to vote on the next day.
But if people decide to take the Charlie Rangel, Tim Geithner route, we can't have enough enforcement officers out there working for the IRS to go out and collect enough taxes to run this government.
Loan subsidized apartments. The fact that he was using letterhead to solicit some of these campaign contributions. He received the money from AIG and the other people that received some of this bailout. The fact that he didn't pay his taxes.
The Federal Reserve, as Congressman Paul points out, is in charge of administering and keeping track of these billions and now trillions of dollars.
This is not an attack on Ben Bernanke or his predecessors. This is good, sound money management.
You know, Acorn should not be allowed to get off with just an internal audit. They need to be looked at much deeper than that. An internal audit for Acorn is the same as asking Secretary Geithner to investigate Chairman Rangel.
Well, you have an organization like Acorn, and there is just complete unaccountability from one acorn. We know many nuts can grow.
But here in the House of Representatives, the rules of behavior are pretty darn sacred too, Madam Speaker.